Okay, so let's do one more exercise on mobile browsers. So let me go back to my Chrome browser. I'll go on more tools, developer options. Okay, so now, as I said in the previous lecture, you see that the mobile is connected. So I'll go and open Chrome browser in my mobile. So once I open the Chrome browser, I would see one URL text edit box here. You see that? Okay. So here you can type your website. Now, there are two types of websites. So if the website is web responsive, then objects in the mobile view or in the web view will always remain same. Okay, so if the website is web responsive. Now, for example, when I say google.com, sorry, of course google.com is web responsive. So that means if you minimize your screen, your website fits into that screen. If you maximize, and your website maximizes to that specific resolution. But basically, objects will not change. So based upon your screen view, your application will be shrinked and placed into specific that location. Now, so when I say google.com, and let me open that in my website, you see that it exactly got shrinked into the mobile view. Okay, so objects will not change in web or mobile. It's all shrinking the screen. Okay, so you have this feature without changing the objects when there is a website with web responsive. So in current days, almost all the websites are web responsive. Okay, in earlier days, so there should be a difference. Now, Facebook. Facebook is not web responsive because for mobile specific views, Facebook have another URL. So when I hit facebook.com and hit an open, you see that. Let me open. Yeah. The URL changed to m.facebook.com. So M stands for mobile. So that means for mobile specific, Facebook guys has came up with one more UI. Okay. If the URL is normal even in the mobile, like google.com, if it is facebook.com, which you will generally see in a web, that means you can say that is it's a web responsive. But these Facebook guys have specifically designed a website for specific mobile views. So that you can understand by clicking, seeing this link URL, m dot. So that means for mobile, the URL is different and the objects might be different. But when I hit a google.com, I did not see any m dot, because objects and the UI are same for both web and mobile. So if they are both the same, you can happily get the objects in your browser only. You need not do in this fashion. Okay, so if the objects are same in the web and mobile, get all your objects in the web browsers using add-ons, Firebug or Chrome Inspector, and then you can just run simply in mobiles. Okay, if they are not same, then you have to go to developer tools, you have to connect to your mobile, you have to enter here, which how we done in the previous lecture for Facebook. Okay, so I'm not teaching you on if it is common both web and mobile, because it's simply I'm just concentrating on specific mobile views. Now, there is a website called Crickbus. So I want to know whether the objects differs from mobile and web or not. So when I hit an open, okay, you see that Crickbus has converted into m.crickbus.com. So that means objects differs from mobile and web. So you need to cast your mobile view into your web browser to get the objects. If they are same, you need not cast. Simply you can hit the URL directly in your browser itself and get that done. Okay, so let me click on this link so that mobile view is casted into my browser. I'll click this, skip this. We are not sure when those ads comes. Okay. Yeah. So if you hit normally crickbus.com in your web browser, the UI will be different. But now I'm casting from mobile, you see that there is a different UI. Okay, so let's try to automate this. And you know, right, how to get an objects. So once the browser is open, let's say I want to click on the menu, and from menu I want to select again this home link, okay, which navigates me to quickbus.com page. It comes back again to same page. So how to get this object? Right click, inspect. Okay, so you see that. I'll spy again. Yeah, so this is the correct object. Anchor a tag link to click on menu. So we have href equals to hash menu, right? So I'll go back to my website and I'll quickly comment all these so that we can write the test in the same class which we have defined of Facebook. Okay, driver dot get, it's quickbus. Just hit quickbus.com, so it will navigate, it reroute your URL to m.quickbus.com. okay, you need not give the specific URL. So this is our target, right? Driver dot find element with xpath, you know, that slash slash tag name. Tag name is anchor a, at the rate attribute href equals to, what's that, hash menu, right? Hash menu. Okay, so we found that xpath and we are just saying to click on it. Okay, so what next? So once we clicked on that, a menu pops up and I want to hit again on home button. And yeah, this is the home. And I have attribute called title. So again, I can write xpath to find the title of quickbus. This time I can use CSS. CSS selector. So in CSS selector, syntax is almost same. Rather than hash hash, I mean rather than slash slash, you won't give any slashes there. Just you will write tag name and you will not also give any at the rates. You will simply pass attribute equals to pass the value. That's it. So you'll just keep this slash slash and at the rate if you want to write it in CSS. Remaining everything is same. Tag name attribute equals to value. And what is the value? Quickbus home. Quick okay, so once it clicked on quickbus, so it will land again on the home page. So I just want to know the URL is changed to m.quickbus.com. okay, once it clicked on home page, so our requirement is to check whether the URL is connecting back to mobile view or not. So to get the URL, you can simply say driver dot get current URL. Yeah, you can print that system dot out println so that we will see the URL. All right. So it should hit quickbus.com in our mobile Chrome browser and it should select menu and thereafter it should click on quickbus home. It should reach the home page and we are grabbing the current URL to see if it navigated correctly or not. So that's it. So let me run this test and we will see the how the execution goes. Okay, so let me close all the browsers in my view. Mobile first. Okay, so okay, I need to start my Appium server. Appium. Okay, so server is started. So let me run the test. I'll open my team viewer to show the results, how it's happening. Okay, so before that, let me open my logs as well. Oops, what happened? You see that Chrome browser is opening, and at the same time monitor your logs as well. So it should click on menu icon now. Yep, it clicked on menu and it's trying to click on home button. You see that it selected home button, and you can skip this ad because okay, so it landed on quickbus.com, and if you see your URL, it says mobile.quickbus.com. Okay, so you are seeing some different URL because it navigated to one ad. So ads are dynamic. You never know when you see them. Okay, so when you are working in QA environment, you will not get all these ads. Okay, developer basically disable the ads in the testing environment, and when it goes to real time, you will see all these ads. Okay, so that will not stop your execution when you have writing your automation scripts in your QA environment. So as we are working on real time devices, we have seen this ad. Okay, yeah, but you have seen right how it navigated from those two pages. So that's it. So anything from here, it's all about how you identify the objects and how you automate that. That's it. So basic setup techniques I have explained very clearly, like how to find an object, how to connect a device, and how to pass the desired capabilities. Okay, so you can actually start the server and these commands which I told you in my initial lecture. Let me write it here. So if you see that your mobile is not recognized to your system, then or sometimes when you hit ADB devices, you will see that device name with unauthorized text. You will see the device key, and if you see unauthorized text when you hit this ADB devices, so that means your device is not properly configured. For to remove that unauthorized, you can simply give this command ADB kill server. First of all, it kills all the servers, and then again you hit this command ADB start server. Okay, and now you say ADB devices, it will definitely give you the device tag, and when you at the same time you will have a pop-up in your mobile saying accept that debug one. Okay, this is just a troubleshooting tip. So some people, I get an email saying when I hit ADB devices, I'm getting unauthorized device and I'm not able to detect. So if you see that, hit these three commands and you will make your device recognizable. All right, so in the next lecture, let's do one more exercise in this quickbus.com only. Okay, we will see how to scroll. We have seen how to scroll in Android, and you will also see how to scroll in iOS in my next lectures, because scrolling is one of the common features in mobile, right? So then how do you scroll in Chrome browser? Okay, I'll show you in the next lecture on that. All right, thank you.